We are P45 and we are Dubs at the Hall.
I'm on that train with me muddy boots. Me rolled up paper and a Tesco box. My eyes are closed but my mouth is wide. My mind is wandering from this daily grind. I'm catching myself to ride. I'm catching myself to ride up town.
We are P45 and we're headlining the Saturday night at Dubs at the Hall. We was asked a few months ago to do this gig and we jumped to it because Rob's got a transporter. We started the band about 2 years ago. We was named as a cover-up and it went a bit pear-shaped, and then we named it P45 due to a record company asking us to change the name, and here we are today. I was in a Paul Weller tribute band. I was a fat fat ginger version of Paul Weller. And then I met Neil, and the Weller thing broke up. And then me and Neil got together and we tried numbers of musicians and that, and that was the cover up. And even Dustin actually come along at one point, but
fucked off again.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. And then it just all sort of went downhill, and then Joe come on board and we started playing the Madness thing, and then we met Rob, and Rob saw something, I don't know what, yeah, and started writing. And then from there it's just taken off to an original thing.
Yeah, I come and see him one night and I just was really sort of really impressed with it, you know, and I thought, how can I worm my way into this band?
And he offered me a score.
No, I would have done it, wouldn't it? No, it's just really impressed. I really saw something there, and so luckily I was, you know, able to jump on board, and then we started writing. And
as soon as we recorded the first song, Top Floor, it was played and on all sorts of radio, and it wasn't even mastered or published or anything. Yeah. And it was straight away, it was banged out on air. So yeah.
We've got a little pockets of following all over the place, which is
massive, up in Newcastle and all sorts of places.
And then down sort of like Reading Way, and then south, you know, sort of. So it's quite not so much London based, funny enough. We've got like large pockets of fans from sort of radio airplay in them areas, and we've sort of like been gigging around them, and it's sort of built up quite a good following, isn't it?
Mm.
Sort of all over the country, really.
People that's influenced me, we play sort of moddy pop ska, but I mean the people that I was influenced by was Mario Lanza, Al Jolson, Neil Diamond, Joseph Locke, Pavarotti, Luciano Pavarotti, Neil Diamond, Tom Jones, all them type of big singers.
Yeah, none of us have really probably come from sort of, well, Dustin's very much in the ska roots, aren't you? But us more into the Northern Soul sort of thing, and jazz really, blues sort of, but we sort of quite like African kind of vibe music as well, and it's kind of a mishmash of that, and we've got into the ska thing and kind of made our own sort of sound up out of it really, haven't we, you know?
We've also got a single coming out on a label called Acid Jazz that's being released in Europe, I think, I'm not too sure, in November.
November.
It's
yeah.
A compilation that somebody called Gary Bushell is putting on that we work really closely with, and Bust a Blood Vessel we've worked really close with. There's loads of people that we've worked really close to, and we don't want to go blowing our own trumpets like a lot of bands do. And
a good job of it, carry on.
People running round on the streets and underground, London boys. Weekend bumblers and forum geeks, London boys. London boys and city girls, London boys and city girls, London boys and city girls, London boys and city girls.
We started writing, didn't we? Started writing a lot
started
of original
writing,
material.
Yeah.
So it went from there.
It's based on like an urban sort of, a lot urban than we're, the
everyday
surroundings
life,
that we are.
All about everyday life.
Yeah.
Know? Probably not so much about love, if the songs are very sort of
everyday life.
From everyday people's problems, you know, debt.
Breakups, living on the top floor.
But we try and do the songs in a light-hearted sort of, they're very up tempo and kind of got a happy bounce to them, even though they're about sort of pretty miserable.
Yeah, they
everyday
are.
Life,
they are,
I suppose,
actually,
really. Like,
they are quite
happy songs about miserable everyday life.
Yeah, they're quite fancy, but the story goes much deeper.
Yeah.
It goes much deeper than what they actually are. And if you actually sat there and listened to the words, they're about you know, Rob only getting to see his kids every other weekend because of, you know, certain, you know, breakups and stuff, and cocaine addiction, and living in debt, and living in council estates, and trying to break out from that. And you know, we're just telling it as it is, basically. And well, to be out here is lovely. Yeah,
but in a happy way, though.
In an happy way. In an happy way, we're happy.
Yeah. Being miserable.
Yeah, we're happy being miserable.
What I normally do, I play a bit of, I play drums, guitar, and I just.
No one's interested in my ideas.
I just put ideas down on a Mac. You know, just drums, bass, guitar, and sort of melody lines, and we sort of like write some lyrics and just go from there, really.
I text him certain words and he comes
sometimes
up with
he's something. Been a big, yeah, sometimes like Jack is sort of, he's quite a big influence really, because of all the nutty things that are going in everyday life. A lot of the songs are influenced by him. One of our songs called Drive Away, which is about
some filling petrol on 15 account.
Yeah,
when I was like bang on the cocaine, I was like proper cocaine addict. I would obviously couldn't afford to buy enough of it because I was constantly using, and I'd fill the car up, and I think I got arrested on 27 accounts of filling the car up with petrol and driving away. And obviously I'm doing community service and what have you now to do that. And he come up with the song Drive Away. It was just enough.
The lyrics are basically quite a lot of people like, that's the one going out on Acid Jazz, you know, that's quite a reasonable label as well. So no, it's it's just a humorous song really, isn't it? But it's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's all right.
Money.
No, it is.
Money.
Yeah, it is. It's a good tune. Yeah. Especially if you know the story behind it, which people round our way do know the story behind it, and have sort of got me sussed. Do you know what I mean?
I'm sitting with the boys in the ties and suits. Their laptops open and their phones are ringing. The smell of the perfume from the obvious girls. Get up my nose and it really smells. I'm catching myself a ride. I'm catching myself a ride. I'm shoes and powder bags, city girls. Cocktail bars hanging out with porn stars, city girls. London boys and 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 city girls.
We're doing the Isle of Wight scooter rallies. We're doing a lot of scooter rallies. We seem to have missed out on all the big festivals this year because we've been more concentrated on writing an album, and we sort of took our eye off the ball slightly. But I'm sure we'll get the bigger festivals next year. We've taken a different approach to what other bands take. A lot of bands take the approach where they've got to do all the festivals, but we've put in the hard work, the groundwork of actually doing all the venues. I mean, playing like 5-6 gigs a week and trying to build up the rapport with the audience, trying to build a big audience, and that's the road we've been going down. Yeah. Hopefully next year we'll start doing the bigger festivals and go that way. We've had airplay and that, but a bit more wouldn't hurt. See what goes on. But I'm pretty sure that if things go the way we want to go, then yeah, we'll be going, you know, we'll be going all over the place, including Europe, and we've got a lot of people that are, you know, behind us, a lot of influential
people. Yeah, in the industry sort of people. Yeah, so we have got, you know.
I mean, you know, we, in a way, we're far behind with other bands, but in a way, we're far in front with other bands.
We do a lot of things are happening, don't we? I mean, we do sort of like all the beat, the selector, all that kind of
thing. Yeah, selector, jewelers, the jam.
We sort of do a lot of support for bands like that.
Lee Thompson from Madness. We're also, well, it looks like we're going to be lined up to do the Minehead thing with Madness. Oh shit, sorry. Yeah. Bollocks. Yeah, no, looking forward to it. No pressure at all. I feel no pressure whatsoever.
It's
going to enjoy
it. It's really nice.
Yeah, because sometimes when we do gigs, we got people watching us and, oh, you've got to do this and you've got to do that and it's got to be like this, it's got to be like that. But at the moment, it's just no pressure whatsoever. No pressure. And for me, it's because I'm not constantly looking around to see who's, you know, always boils down for me, it always boils down to the drug side of things where I'm constantly, do you know what I mean? But there's just no pressure whatsoever. Just get up there, do our thing. If you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't.
Like being involved more with this sort of the V-dub thing anyway, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it, definitely. You know, it's get home and watch men behaving badly and play FIFA. Yeah, www.p45band.co.uk. Click on the link that doesn't work.
I do now.
And join the Facebook page and keep up to date with single releases and what have you and album releases and blah-de-blah-de-blah. And keep it real. People running round on the streets and on the ground, London boys. Weekend footballers are born geeks, London boys. London boys ain't city girls, 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 London boys ain't city girls.